Bonnie invited me to the shooting range.
What?
Yeah, Bonnie says she goes every week. Take him to the park. I want him to get some fresh air.
Fresh air is bad for a kid, Lois. Look at Michael J. Fox.
You are taking Stewie to the park.
Is that your little one there?
Oh, no, it's just the way I'm sitting. Damn, I wish I could go to the clam. Huh?
You gotta get down to the clam, man. There's like 60 clowns in here.
I can't. I gotta watch Stewie. Okay, it's okay, as long as I can still see him. Okay, Stewie, there you are, safe and sound. Daddy can still see you. Oh, hey, Lois. Hey, it's hard to hear you over the sound of joyful children in the park.
Are you and Stewie having a good time?
Hey, Lois, it's me, the baby.
Hi, Stewie. I'm on my way home.
All right, cool. Bring some beef jerky, maybe.
Oh, there's my boy.
Hey, what happened to my new friend? That kid who sort of looks like me from behind.
Wait a minute. Stewie, what happened to your head? Well, you're not Stewie. I gotta get you back to the park and find... I'm your new dad. My name is Peter, and I work at the brewer... NASA. I work at NASA. See? There's a human baby in there. Asleep in Stewie's overalls.
Peter, please get out of my way.
Oh, Jacob! Where's your little hat?
He didn't have a hat.
Oh, I am so sorry.
I took a bath with the dad.
Oh, my baby's back home. Mommy missed you.
Congratulations, Lois. You passed the test.
How the hell can you possibly mistake another baby for Stewie?
Now calm down, Lois. You're going to say something you don't mean.
Oh, no, I'm not. You're an idiot. You left a helpless baby in a public park, and that's something only an idiot would do.
I'm not an idiot. I hate to sound like every woman ever, but I'm depressed.
Don't engage.
Why?
Damn it!
Lois called me an idiot.
So? Peter, maybe you need to broaden your horizons. You know, read a book. Travel.
Oh, yeah, I love traveling. You see new things, inconvenience thousands of people.
Hey, kid, get in my van and I'll give you some candy.
No, my mom says I shouldn't.
Stella, I need you to go to Chicago on Thursday.
If you've got business traveling that needs to be done, I'm your guy.
Griffin, I'm not going to look over there until you first assure me you've got pants on.
You see, my wife thinks I'm an idiot. She's always making me feel small and insignificant.
So you'd be willing to take that trip to Chicago for the company?
Yeah, you know, I was just saying I need to broaden my horizons.
Mr. Griffin, I believe you have something for me?
Yes, I do, Mr. Franks.
Terrific. We were completely out of these tubes. Well, thank you all for coming. Good day.
Wow. Chicago. The San Francisco treat.
Hi, welcome to the museum.
Thanks. Hey, just to be clear, I should touch everything, right?
No, please don't touch anything.
Hey there, Chief. Dennis Farina here. And welcome to our museum. Just so you know, I'll be eating through most of this. Now, here is a naked chick made completely out of marble. I gotta wonder, and I'm sure you do too.
He did a great job with the vagina. This is only Chicago. From now on, I'm gonna volunteer for every business trip and see all the great stuff that's... Father has returned.
Dad!
Oh, Peter!
How were all your business trips?
Oh, exemplary, Chris.
Peter, you sound so refined. Are you intelligent now?
Affirmative. That means yes.
That's hump.
Affirmative. 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 Oh, my God! Affirmative!
Mom, Dad, the TV's broken!
Actually, Chris, I got rid of our television. This is our new bookshelf.
Oh, these are some of my favorite books and authors.
Oh? What are you reading right now?
He's got you on the ropes now.
Well, I'm actually rereading a lot of stuff.
How'd you do it?
Well, Lois, some of it came from books, some came from museums, and honestly, a lot of it just came from travel. Pity a man in familiar places who yet feels like a stranger.
You're the dick who wrote that in the bathroom!
We will have to learn not to giggle at smart things that sound dirty but are not. Balzac. Homo erectus.
Hey, Lois.
No, I wasn't. Ugh, Brian, thank God it's just you. You know how PETA thinks TV rots the mind. I can't take this anymore, Brian, and the kids can't either. PETA's become a nightmare.
Wait, I thought this is what you always wanted, for PETA not to be an idiot.
If visiting San Francisco and New York made PETA smart, maybe if we send him to the dumbest city in the whole country, it'll bring back the old PETA. How was your trip?
Oh, amazing. I saw a wet t-shirt contest using chocolate milk. It was at the Tucson Philharmonic.
Hi, Chris. How was school? Wait, what's that note pinned to your backpack?
Bet it's from a girl in the lunchroom who wants a taste of corn dog.
I'm sorry, Mom. I haven't been doing too great in school lately.
Well, that's very disappointing. I guess your father and I will have to talk to the principal and figure out how to handle this.
Chris seems to be struggling in his classes, and often when kids have trouble in school, it's because something is going on at home. His only hope is his history final tomorrow. If he fails that, I'm afraid he'll have to repeat ninth grade.
This seems more like a phone call. All right, Chris, you got a lot riding on this history exam tomorrow. I'm going to help you study by nailing your door shut. That way, you'll have no choice but to hit the books. Lois, I don't have the phone! Stop sending pictures!
I already sent four more!
Chris, put down the phone!
Hey, Chris. Just wanted to see how the studying's going.
You guys, I've been at this all night, and I haven't learned a thing. If I fail ninth grade, I won't amount to anything. I'll end up being one of those bus drivers that parents don't completely trust.
We gotta do something. If he doesn't pass this test, he's gonna have to... Hey, maybe there's a way to actually show Chris history with my time machine.
You know, that's really nice of you, Stewie.
Huh?
You're dreaming. And there's so much to learn. All right, I've got the return pad, and the time machine is powering up right now. We should be leaving any moment.
This thing is awesome.
All right, Chris, I reviewed your textbook and I've programmed a tour of the various historical events that you'll need to know for your exam. So pay close attention. This is Paris, 1920. This bar is where famous American writers like Ernest Hemingway would go for a drink.
Oh my God, there he is! I mean, God, if only we could get rid of these damn arms and attach the pen directly to the heart, right? You guys, I got his pen!
Oh my God, where are we?
Omaha Beach, 1944. This is D-Day. George Washington is about to boldly cross the Delaware.
What's on his arms?
Those are water wings. He was terrified of the water.
Easy!
Jane Austen? I don't think she's on my history test, Stewie.
Oh, I know. We're just here to release pent-up time travel farts.
Awesome!
Yeah!
Okay, time for some recent history. This is the 1990s.
This is the entire 1990s?
Yes.
Hey, Pavlov, you dog-teasing dick! How's this for positive reinforcement?
All right, Chris, that was the British Parliament, 1912. Next, we... I say, that looks like a young Charlie Chaplin. For God's sake, Chris, you clearly have not paid attention to anything we've shown you. You're absolutely helpless. Your problem isn't book learning, it's that you're a moron. This whole trip has been a complete waste of time.
If I'm such a moron, then how did I get on a fancy boat? Oh, and I took your fancy smoke detector.
My God, he's got the return pad. Brian, we've got to get on that ship.
Oh, thank God. Wasn't sure we were gonna make it. Come on, Stewie. We gotta find Chris and the return pad before it's too late.
All right, let's split up. I'll go search in first class. You go down to steerage and wade through the gross Irish and Italians.
Excuse me. Have any of you seen a blonde teenage boy?
Who's asking? Yeah, who the hell are you? And I'm the baby!
Also, I gave the string quartet the sheet music for Highway to the Danger Zone.
You have the sheet music for Highway to the Danger Zone?
I see Chris right now.
Really? Where?
I'm gonna go ahead and bet he's the guy with the whole chicken stuck on his head.
Hey, you're not Chris. Chris, there you are!
Well, 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 if it isn't booger breath and the mushroom tip.
Look, Chris, just give us that thing you took so we can all get home. Quick, Chris, Stewie, get on! To home!
Or I'll just put in the coordinates.
Damn! The return pad! It's been destroyed! We have to somehow get to dry land.
Dry land? Stewie, almost everyone on the Titanic died!
All right, calm down, Brian.
This isn't gonna work.
Brian, this is our only hope. The majority of people who got on those lifeboats were women of noble birth.
There's a lifeboat?
Yeah, but it's got one of those funny Southwest lifeboat attendants. Hey, they learned it. What a bunch of pros.
Dear God, we're stuck here. We're going to drown on the Titanic.
Oh, no, we're not. Everyone, move over. We're getting on this boat.
You just saved our lives. Thank you.
Well, I was wrong earlier when I called you a moron. You're throw people off the boat smart. And frankly, I'm starting to think that's the best kind to be.
Well, looks like one ship was saved today. A relationship.
Thanks, Dream Brian. Thanks, Dream Stewie. Brian, Stewie, I just had the most amazing dream.
Hey, everybody, I'm Teacher Doug, and I don't believe in tests.
Yay!
Peter, I was at the park with Stewie, and someone stole his tricycle.
Stupid thief. It's got a vanity plate that won't even apply to him.
I only had 9 payments left on that thing. I'm gonna find that tricycle. I'll just have 4 to 5 beers to stop the shaking, and then I'll go outside.
I've been sitting here for the last 3 hours selling lemonade. Would you like a nice cool glass?
You couldn't have been here for 3 hours, or the ice cubes in your pitcher would have melted.
Here's the tricycle. You were right, Peter. This kid's a thief.
We did it. Well, look at us. You know, we make a great team, guys.
I'm kind of over that thing. Now I'm way into wooden beads you move along wires.
Whoa. Oh, yeah.
I'll give you 50 cents to find my lucky baseball card.
Guys, we're in business.
Yeah.
All right, guys, this will be the headquarters for our new detective agency. This milk crate will be my chair. This overturned rain barrel will be my desk. So you say this gumball machine took your dime and didn't give you a gumball? Well, I'll take care of that. This gumball machine takes quarters, not dimes. It's a setup.
Just this morning, we've had multiple reports of stolen items. Someday, a rain will come and wash all this scum off the streets.
Forwarding, forwarding, forwarding. And there we go. Our thief.
See? There's nothing here. Just a weird life-size lady doll made out of all the stuff that got stolen.
No! Don't hurt Heather! Don't hurt my girlfriend!
Chris is still in his room with that disgusting homemade sex doll. He actually thinks it's his girlfriend.
I know, it's weird.
Maybe it's our fault Chris has such a screwed-up idea about what a relationship is. I mean, let's be honest, we're not exactly the model of a healthy marriage.
Just last week, I let you watch me complain after eating too many hot wings.
Oh, why did you let me do this, Lois?
Sex doll? I wish. Heather hasn't even let me get to second base.
Wait, hang on. What's second base? Is that touching one of the cabbages? And look, if you really want to learn how to bang that thing, there's no better teacher than your old dad. After all, I'm the guy who taught old Asian people how to get on the subway. Okay, Chris, now women really dig those fireman calendars. So we're going to go inside and get some sexy shots of you doing fireman stuff.
The truth is, I don't care if we never take it to the next level, physically. I just really like spending time with you.
Good morning, everybody. I think Heather will be eating breakfast standing up this morning, if you know what I mean.
This is all your fault. You never listen to anything I say.
Look, you told me to talk to him. I talked to him. And now you're nagging me about it? Oh, Lois, thank God. Listen, I can't decide what I want for breakfast tomorrow. Can you make me a sample tray?
You know what, Peter? I'm not talking to you right now. Oh, Peter, they're beautiful.
Read the card.
To Heather from Chris.
Lois, before you say anything, I also got you a gift. It's a Katherine Heigl mask for you to wear while we have sex.
Oh, my God. Chris treats that pile of junk better than Peter treats me.
What's the matter, Lois? Need to get in the mood?
Chris, where have you been?
Heather and I went for a tandem bike ride and then had lunch at a gastropube.
Nope.
Well, tomorrow Heather and I are going to the park to picnic and fly kites.
How a man should treat his woman.
Oh, Lois, your breath smells like eggs. Talk that way.
Can your father and I come with you?
What are you doing? You can't let him keep thinking that doll is real.
I know, but I just want Peter to see what a thoughtful man looks like for one afternoon. It's fun going on a picnic, isn't it, Peter?
Yeah. Will you hold this beer bottle while I try to kick the top off it?
Ow, damn it!
You moved it!
Those raindrops are falling on my head and they keep
fallen because I'm free.
Peter, don't you see what's going on here? Your son's relationship with that doll is better than our own marriage.
Mom, Heather's disappeared. Have you seen her?
No, I haven't, sweetheart.
I miss her so much.
I know, honey, but if you give it a little time, I'm sure you'll get over her.
His brain ain't right, but it's fun.
I see you're sad and also sitting on the remote.
Why did Heather leave me?
Sometimes when life's got you down, you gotta stand up for a second.
Here we go. Oh, no, I hit input. Oh, no. Oh, God, we may have to throw away the television.
Boy, he's really upset.
Ugh, I can't deal with anything until I've had my after-nap coffee.
Hey, Chris. I see you turned your hat around so you can really get in there.
Well, what do you care? What does anybody care? You did this?
You stabbed her. Like 50 times.
I was kind of jealous of it, so I guess I went a little crazy. If you ever treat a real woman the way you treat that doll, you're gonna make her very happy.
Really? I guess there's just one thing left to do.
What's that?
Give me that knife. I gotta cut out the baby.
Oh my God!
It's made of Skittles.
From now on, I am gonna be treating you like garbage.
Oh, Peter.
No talking unless I say. Hi, Peter.
How'd she know your name?